Hi, in this video we're going to look at how to put together a project so that you'll be able to read from a data file and then also write to a data file. So I would recommend that you start with online GDB and make for sure that you have the concepts working, because it's the easiest one of the IDEs to make this work. After you've tested your code here, then you can go back and try one of the other IDEs if you want, or you can just stick with online GDB. So I've opened it up. We're in C++ 17, and this is the example program. So we'll change this to be the IO stream. We just need that anytime we're going to do the input output. And then since we're working with files, we're going to do include fstream. So that's our main include file for working with files. And then in main, we're going to have to set up a stream for input and then also set up a stream for output. So let's work on our output stream first, and then we'll go back and add the input. So for output stream, it's going to be std colon colon, because we're coming out of the C standard library, O for output, F for file, stream, and then whatever you're going to call the stream. So your book uses F out for output. I'm just going to stick with that same F out, but you could use any valid identifier. So you could name this with any name that would work for any of the variable names. You can open it separately, but the easiest way to do it is just to go ahead and do a parentheses after F out and then put in the name of the file that you're going to create. So our name of the file in this case would be output, and let's just stick with the text format because that would be easy to open up later in Windows or in the Finder if you're working off of Mac. Then we'll do a semicolon. So this statement will create an output stream called fout, and it will link it with this output file. If this output file has not been created yet, then it will create the output file. So now let's do a hello world program. But let's print hello world to the file. So you'll notice that a couple of things are really similar, and then a couple of things are different. So when you're using cout, it's cout, less than, whatever you're sending to it, and then you've got the inline. But the big difference here is instead of doing std colon colon, you can just use fout. In fact, if you put std colon colon in front of it, it won't really understand what you're trying to do, because fout is defined locally now in your program. Versus cn and cout, they're defined back in the library, back in IOStream. So let's run it. And you'll notice that output.txt just pops up here. So it's created the output file, and you can see the hello world that's in here. So let's go back to our main.cpp. Now let's create an input file and just read a couple numbers from it. So we're going to have to add that input file to our project. So we'll click on the new file icon. And extensions are really important in C++. So again, I would recommend, since just to keep it simple, let's just give everything a .txt extension. So this would be input.txt. Click on OK. And here's our input file. Now we're still dealing with the same C++ editor here under language. So sometimes it'll pop up some kind of weird stuff, but just ignore that. So it's trying to pop up this character. So I'm going to just put a couple of values in here, and then I would always recommend leaving a blank line at the end just to make for sure that you don't accidentally hit end of file trying to read that last record. And then these would be our records in the file. You could separate them with either spaces, or you could put a return after each one. I've just put a return after each one. So I'm going to save this file. And it wants me to be logged in on my project, but I think I'll be okay. So I'm going to go back to main.cpp. Now I'm going to do std colon colon I for input f and then stream. So the first one was OF stream for output. This one is IF stream I for input. We'll call this one FN, and the same thing. We'll call it input.txt and we'll put a semicolon at the end. Now we've created the stream FN and we've linked it with this file input.txt. Now we just need to use our file. So we need a variable. We have numbers in there. It looks like they're probably floats or doubles. So we'll do double x. We'll declare a variable so that we can read some values in. And then we'll do fn greater than x. So notice this looks very similar to what you do with cn, right? But with cn, you'd have to do std colon colon cn. With fn, you don't, because you defined it, again, just right in your program, right on line 16. So now let's mix our input and output, and let's print whatever we read from the file to the console window. And ideally we do this with a loop, but I'm just trying to keep this one just really simple. So I'm just going to copy and paste the same read and print. So fn is reading. See how it is printing. And then let's try and read one more time, as we should only have three data points in there that are readable. So let's see what would happen if we try to go for a fourth one. Let's run it. And so when we try to go for that fourth one, when it reads, it just crashes the input stream, and we don't quite have the flags yet. We'll talk more about them later in the week. But the idea is once that stream crashes, then it's no longer changing, so that X still has the same value that it did when you tried to read up here. So you read the 3.14159 into X. It still has the same value, and so when you print it out, you get the same value. So it's kind of annoying with C++ because it doesn't give you an error message, but at the same time, it's actually a good thing because it did give you an internal error message. You just have to know and go to check for it, but the error message doesn't crash your program. So when something goes wrong with the stream, you can go back and check and fix it. You don't have to exit your program to fix the stream and then try and run your program again. So it looks like it's not a good thing, but it is actually a good thing that C++ does this. But this is definitely something that you want to be aware of. So try building this really simple file program and build it in online GDB and see if you can get both your output file and your input file working and linked to your project. And if everything's working here, then try the same process with the other IDE that you're using, if you're using another IDE. The thing that'll be a little bit more complicated, though, is you'll have to make sure that input.txt gets linked in with your project and also gets in the correct location in the folder. So I'll show you some examples of that later. But this is the first place to start. Thanks for watching.